Hey guys, it's Toby, and this is the £500 Gaming PC Build Guide. Let's go! Alright, first off we have the AMD Ryzen 5 2600. The 2600 is arguably one of the best processors in the world right now in terms of price to performance. What you're getting here with this CPU is 6 cores and 12 threads with a base clock of 3.4GHz and a turbo boost up to 3.9. Now it's not the newest processor in the world, it's been out for a couple years now and there is a newer version of it available. However, for this build, it is perfect as it's going to be great whenever you're playing anything that's CPU intensive like Cities Skylines, GTA 5, any of the Assassin's Creed games, or if you're doing anything like video editing, rendering, stuff like that. Stuff that's really demanding on the CPU, this processor is going to handle it without any issues at all. With this processor, we're also kind of future-proofing ourselves as we won't need to upgrade it within the next 5 years or so, and plus you can also overclock it beyond the 3.9 turbo boost. This makes it a great choice for our build. Now moving on to our graphics card, we're going to be using the Zotac GTX 1650. The 1650 we have here is a mini overclock version. It's still got 4GB of GDDR5 RAM, and it's going to be able to play pretty much any game you throw at it at 1080p at high to ultra settings. So everyone's favourite games like League of Legends, Dota 2, Minecraft, PUBG, Rainbow Six, CSGO, CSGO 2, I mean Valorant, Overwatch, Tarkov, you name it. This graphics card is capable of playing all of them at 1080p, at 60fps, at high or ultra settings if it's an older game like League or CSGO, without any issues at all. Whilst this is a very capable card with the popular titles, its performance when it comes to newer releases and AAA games is also pretty good, however you might need to turn the settings down a bit. So if you're playing something new like Doom Eternal, you might not be able to get 1080 60 at ultra settings, so you might have to bump it down to high or medium. In addition, when it comes to future releases like Cyberpunk 2077 or Assassin's Creed Valhalla, you again may not be able to play them at full ultra settings at 1080p, you might have to bump it down. Gaming at 1440p and above is also possible with this graphics card, however again you might need to turn the settings down depending on the game in order to get a smooth frame rate. But overall, this graphics card does pretty much everything you'll expect at a decent price point. It has all the connectivity options too, like HDMI, DVI and DisplayPort, so you don't have to worry about that, and in the future we can always upgrade it to something a bit more beefy. Now moving on to our motherboard, we're going to be using the Gigabyte B450M DS3H. The DS3H is a micro ATX motherboard, which means it is slightly smaller than the standard size ATX motherboards. However, this does not mean it is limited in any way. It's got all the standard connectivity options you'll expect, such as SATA 3.0, USB 3.1 support on the front and back panel, 10/100/1000 Ethernet, HD audio, support for an M.2 drive, which is great as we have one in our build, in addition to also having PCI Express 3.0 for our graphics, and support for up to 4 DDR4 RAM slots. And coming onto the RAM, we're going to be using 8GB of Corsair Vengeance LPX. Now there's not much to say about this other than the fact that it is low profile, that's what LPX stands for, and it's clocked at 3000MHz, which is the sweet spot for a Ryzen 5 2600 to work with. Also, this is only one stick of 8GB RAM, so you do have the ability to upgrade in the future to 16GB by buying the exact same RAM stick again and adding it to your build. Now some people do prefer getting 2 sticks of 4 instead of 1 stick of 8, however that does limit your upgrade options in the future, and whilst Ryzen might perform slightly better with 2 sticks of RAM instead of 1, it doesn't make that much of a difference when you have a dedicated graphics card. Now coming onto our storage options, we're going to be using the Western Digital Green 120GB M.2 SSD. This SSD is going to be the home of our operating system along with any of the programs or games that we'll be using on a regular basis, as having them on an SSD helps them boot up significantly quicker than if they were on a hard drive. And speaking of hard drives, we're going to be using the 1TB Western Digital Blue for all of our other storage needs. So all of your documents, videos, photos, games that are too big for the SSD, anything else you can think of, all of these are going to be going on the 1TB drive. If you find yourself needing more storage options, you can always upgrade this to the 2TB or the 4TB variant, or you can just buy another one of these later down the line as these are so reliable and these are one of the go-to hard drives for most of our builds. Now coming onto our power supply, we're going to be using the EVGA 500W. The 500W is an 80 plus white certified power supply, which means you're going to get clean and efficient power. It is a non-modular PSU with everything else you'll expect, such as surge protection, over and under voltage protection, 3-year warranty, and a quiet 120mm fan. And finally, coming onto the case, we're going to be using the Cougar MG130G. You may not have heard of Cougar before, but they do make some very interesting and crazy cases. But this is a standard micro ATX case, which means it is going to house all of our components without any issue at all. And speaking of housing our components, it has a tempered glass side panel, which means we can see all of our build in all of its glory, and you can add some RGB lighting strips to make it look even nicer. Now, case options are kind of subjective, so I will always include some alternatives, which you can find linked in the build guide in the description below. And yeah, that's it guys, thanks for watching. Leave us a like if you like this video, leave us some feedback or any questions you might have down below in the comments, I will try to respond as quickly as possible. If you're planning on buying any or all of these components, please use our links as it does help us out quite a bit. In addition, check out our social media, especially our Twitch page, as we'll be more active on there. Don't forget to subscribe, and we'll catch you next time.